In this example, we're looking at an isothermal plug flow reactor, and it's used for a reaction that results in a phase change. So A in the gas phase, 10 molecules of A make one molecule B, which is a solid, given the rate constant. And we're going to assume that the solid occupies a small enough volume because of the large difference in density between the gas and the solid that we can ignore the actual volume of the solid. The small particles are just entrained in the gas phase. And so we're giving conditions coming into the reactor and the reactor volume. And the question is, what is the exit conversion from the reactor? First thing we're going to want to do is draw a diagram to represent the system. So this represents the tube, and coming in is a gas. It's at 450 Kelvin and 10 bar, and the molar flow rate, so F will be used to indicate the molar flow rate, subscript 0 is the inlet value, is 120 moles per minute. Leaving is the unreacted A as a gas, and then B is a solid, and at the same conditions. And so what we're going to do to solve this is first write down a mass balance or a material balance on A. Plug flow reactor, the change in the molar flow rate with the cumulative volume. Volume equals 0 when we start. Volume equals 100 liter at the end. The change in number of moles with volume is the rate of reaction. In this case, we have rate constant, and the rate constant indicates it's a first-order reaction. Minus sign because it's a reactant, so the flow rate is decreasing. And then we put a 10 here to count for the stoichiometry. We're assuming K is defined as normally used, so we need to put a stoichiometric coefficient. Now this is going to simplify for this system, minus 10 K Ca0. So the concentration of A doesn't change. The gas phase is always just pure A. The molar flow rate is going to change, but because the solid doesn't occupy a significant volume, Ca0 is a constant. That's the concentration at the inlet. And that means we can integrate this. We integrate from our inlet value to our outlet value, and this is what we want to determine, because if we know the outlet molar flow rate, we can determine conversion. And we'll integrate from the inlet to 100 liters. So this is just FA minus FA0 when we substitute the limits. And this is minus 10 K Ca0 times 100 liters. Now we know the values of these constants, so we're going to put those in. We still need the value for the concentration of A. We can get that from the pressure and the temperature and the ideal gas law. So note, I've substituted for the gas constant in units so that our concentration is going to be moles per liter. So I'm going to substitute that for Ca0. We can calculate this difference. It's minus 81 moles per minute. We're interested in the conversion, which is FA0 minus FA divided by FA0. So this is now plus for FA0 minus FA over FA0, which is 120 moles per minute. And we get a conversion of 0.675. Often write conversion percent round to two significant figures. 68% conversion of the feed reactant A.